So here with another squash girl, could you introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Susie Pierpont, currently ranked 35 in the world. No, 32 in the world.
How, Susie, as a member of the Whisper board, are we going to take squash in North America to the next level?
To be honest, we don't really need to do anything at the moment. Squash is probably growing faster in North America than it is in any other country in the world. There's a phenomenal amount of juniors playing within the East Coast of America. What we need to focus on is spreading out into Middle America and over to the West Coast. I think that US Squash's junior development program is attempting to create maybe an under-23s tour and an under-25s tour whereby graduating squash players get to play in some tournaments. I've had a few U25 tournaments this summer that have gone really, really well, and we hope that that tour will continue to grow, because that goes across the board. It's male, female, and it can go right down through the levels, which is great.
Well, I have, these are like the seventh grade team. We have two seventh grade teams, and I love bringing the girls over to this tournament. It's nice to have them see what professional play is like, see how well the women play, and how good sports they are in court, and just the etiquette and sportsmanship. So it's all part of it.
We're about to get your coach on camera. Well, why don't you tell me about her real quickly?
Good luck, Miranda.
Miranda.
Yeah, she's such
so
a good.
Nice.
Yeah.
She's so nice, and she's such a good.
She's amazing.
She got win.
Oh, we coach the Greenwich Academy grade 7 girls, and they come to Round Hill, and we coach them every day, so they came out and watched me play, which is really nice.
And are you ranked? Are you on the women's tour, actually?
I'm ranked 51 in the world right now, so I played in the tournament, and I lost today.
Oh, well, that's too bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, last time I lost to tenure in 4 games in November last year, and so I guess I knew that it was going to be a really tough match, and you know, she's always tough to play, and you know, she's one of the toughest minded person on tour. Yeah, so I'll play the winner of the next match, which is on Naya.
She's number 2.
Oh, Latasha Khan.
Yeah, she's number 2 seed.
Yeah, so you know, we'll see how it goes.
Hi, I'm Omnia Abdulkawi. I'm number 7 in the world and number 2 seed in this tournament.
Okay, so what's the plan for this year?
Actually, I'm playing match by match. I'm not thinking about the final, you know. I played today with Latasha in the first round, so I'm pleased to get out of it 3-love. So tomorrow I'm playing Casey Brown. She beat me last time 3-love, so we're going to see what's going to happen tomorrow.
Would you like to say hello to any friends back home, maybe some family?
Shagauna o khaliku maina.
There you go.
Well, it's great to be part of it. I mean, I've been watching these games since the early 80s. My dad took me to see Sharif Khan play when at the field club. I think this whole sort of event really got going in the early 80s. I'm glad just to be able to give back a little bit after all these years, because the players come out here, they play their hearts out. You know, the matches are fabulous. I mean, they bring a lot to our town.
Did you see many balls over there on the right wall?
I saw a lot of squash balls.
It's good he had you to carry him over there on that wall.
Absolutely. Yeah, that's the same thing he said to me.
I can tell you that in case you missed the scorecard here, these are two of the best squash players in the world, and it's a big honor for us to have them here. The girls don't have to play everywhere, and so to have number 6, number 7 in the world come to Greenwich and play squash for us is a great honor. We're really pleased you guys made the effort. Thank you. And what can you say about Allison Waters? She has come to this event consistently, and 2 finalists, the 3rd time's the charm. Allison has clearly elevated her game to the preeminent levels in squash, one of the top squash players in the world, and the winner of the 2010 Harrow Greenwich Open is Allison Waters. Congratulations.
Thank you.
say massive thanks to Rob and Noel. They've done a fantastic job of organising the tournament. And everyone involved at all the three clubs. It's good to see everyone here supporting. I'd like to thank Mark and Harrow for, and all the other sponsors of the of this tournament. All the families that have held all the girls. We love coming to America, and I think that's one of the reasons, because everyone treats us so nicely. And I've been staying with Heather Mosley, who's sat there. Thank you very much for having me for the week. It's been fantastic. And hopefully I can come back and win again next year. Thank you very much.
Russell, left side, 1-2.
What do you have to do to win the ninth?
Win.
Now, you had a long match yesterday. Did you prepare any differently for this match? Because knowing you were tired, the other team was going to be fresh, or did you just go in, you know, all out?
Didn't really do much different. Just we knew we had to come out and play as hard as we could. And unfortunately, we had a two-hour battle yesterday, and they didn't even get on court. Right. So
what did you think about these two? It was an upset yesterday, playing JR and Preston. So were you expecting that at all? Have you played them in the past? And how did you gear up for playing, knowing that they had a big, tough five gamer yesterday?
We just decided to sort of work on JR a bit and try and get him back and forth. But his positioning and his understanding of the game is so good. And his hands are exceptional. So to sort of actually get him moving without Preston covering him, it was actually a pretty tough feat because the ball got slower and slower, and this is a very slow court to begin with. So it was very tough. They sort of lulled us into a very slow game, which we didn't adapt to until the fifth game.
So we saw you were covering a lot of balls in the back left. Was there a strategy there, or was that more an endurance factor kicking in?
It was more of an endurance factor. I felt like I wasn't seeing a whole lot of balls on the right, and partner was seeing plenty, so it was an easy one for me to go take care of.
I started off playing with Steve, who's a pro at the Roundhill, so we always had a big crowd here, and everybody's seemed to continue to support me since then. It's always a great event. We get looked after very well with, places to stay, rides to the different clubs. Great crowd today, great crowd yesterday, the whole weekend actually, it's been great. So it's always an amazing tournament.
What a tough match today. We went five games, a couple hours, and after a tough match they had yesterday, they sneaked out a big win yesterday, and they came right back and played really hard. And we're just really thankful for everyone's support and being here in Greenwich and all the sponsors and patrons, and it's just a really good positive environment. And squash is a beautiful sport with beautiful people, so just thank you so much.
Well, how many times is this for you to win the North American?
This is nine.
It's a very impressive feat.
Thank you.
Stars fading, but I linger on, dear.
Oh, how you linger on.
Still craving your kiss.
How you crave my kiss.
Now I'm longing to linger till dawn, dear. Just sing this.
Give me a little kiss, sweet dreams, till sunbeams find you. Sweet dreams that leave all worries behind you. But in your dreams, whatever they be, dream a little dream of me.
Buzz, 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 buzz. Fading, but I linger on, dear. Still craving your kiss. Yeah, I'm longing to linger till dawn, dear. Just saying this. Sweet dreams, dreaming.
Till something's fine, you keep dreaming.
Gotta keep dreaming.
Leave the worries behind you. But in your dreams, whatever they be, you've gotta make me a promise. Promise to